In today's video, I'm going to show you guys how to take your macro photography to the next level by adding this one effect to your highlights. Roll that intro. What is up, guys? Welcome back to the Raw Factory. My name is Jacob, and the goal of this channel is to help you become a better food and product photographer. To begin, open up your macro shot in Photoshop. Now, to add those amazing sparkles to your highlights, you need to open up the Sparkle Photoshop file, which I'll leave linked below so you guys can download and access. Luckily for me though, I have mine ready in the next tab. Click and drag the sparkle layer over onto the next tab and drop it on top of your image. To make it transparent, change the blend mode to screen. Now drag it to the area that has a highlight. Doesn't that look good? Although it is a little too bright. I think reducing their opacity by 10% would help it blend in better. Now all you need to do is duplicate the layer and move it to another spot that has a highlight. You might find that you need to use your keyboard arrows to be more precise with the placement of the sparkle. To easily duplicate the sparkle layer, just click Command J on your keyboard and move the sparkle to the next highlight. Keep in mind that you can adjust the size of the sparkle by clicking and dragging the corners of the sparkle layer. Just ensure that you have the move tool selected. Now, another good tip is to rotate each sparkle to help them look different from one another. Again, to do this, ensure you are on the move tool. Click on a sparkle and then point your mouse slightly away from one of the corners. You will see the rotate icon appear. Click and then drag your mouse either from left or right. All right, because I've given you guys so many tips in this one video, I'm going to give you one more. One more tip. If you have the auto select feature on in Photoshop, it will allow you to select any layer without having to find it in the layers panel. How good is that? You can click on any sparkle with your mouse and it will auto select it in the layer panel. I mean, if that isn't the best tip of this video, I don't know what is. And that's it. Do it for as many highlights as you like. Once you're happy with all the sparkles and the way the image is looking, head over to export. Save it out as a JPEG. I like to export my images for social media around 1 megabyte. As you can see, by choosing excellent, my image size is at 1.1 megabytes. And that's it, guys, you're done. Well, that is all for me today, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you got something out of it, like, comment, and subscribe to help others find this video. And I'll see you all in the next one. Remember, don't wait, make something creative today. Catches.